Hello everyone. 2 weeks ago, I made a video about why you probably shouldn't buy cheap refurbished computers, especially ones that can't be upgraded to Windows 11, and since I received some negative feedback, I've decided to delve deeper into this topic. Now, I'm sure most YouTubers wouldn't post a sequel to a disliked video, but I care for my audience, and I really do want to make a better video with positive feedback. I care about your negative comments, even though I'm in a position where I can afford to basically do whatever I want. I mean, I don't monetize my videos and, you know, I'm not a large channel where a single disliked video will have serious impact, and what is more, a disliked video still gets views and engagement, and a negative comment is still a comment for the algorithm. But despite all of that, I still want to make the sequel, not only because I care, but also because this time I will cover more aspects of the topic. And with that being said, let's start. And we're going to start with the 7th gen Intel Core processor, which, taking the i7-7700K as an example, was released in the beginning of 2017, or 7 years ago. This is the newest CPU generation, which Microsoft refused to support for Windows 11. Other ones like the 6th gen were released in 2016 and are even older. As you can see, the 7th gen is obsolete in every possible way, with the marketing status being discontinued and the end of support notification issued. Security updates have stopped since the end of March. As we mentioned, these CPUs are at least 7 years old, and according to statistics, households in the US replace their PCs when they're only 5 years old. I don't say that people always buy the newest CPU there is, but a 7 or 8 year old CPU is definitely reaching the end. Even if you can squeeze one or two more years out of it, it doesn't seem like a future-conscious decision. Of course, these articles claim 16 GB of RAM, and it seems like a huge selling point, but in reality it just tries to steer the attention away from the truth, that is, that the CPU is a dinosaur. And don't get me wrong, these CPUs are definitely still capable of doing some basic tasks, but Windows is not what you will be using, which brings me on to the next thing I want to discuss, and that's Linux. In the previous video, I said Linux won't save these machines from their age and the fact that they are outdated. But that isn't quite true, because if you buy one now and use it till, say, 2030, then well, Linux is in fact an option. And while this seems appealing considering the price, from my standpoint for example, this doesn't seem so good, as $200 are a considerable amount. In fact, I tend to use computers all the way until they are 10 to 12 years old. And these machines are already about 8 years old, which means their useful life has diminished significantly. But say you buy such a PC, because $200 are practically nothing in the US, and you also maybe get a warranty. Tell me, why do you need this computer? What are you going to use it for? Is it that your current PC is an, I don't know, Pentium 4 or something that you need a cheap upgrade for? Probably not. And I'm certain that you also have an older PC or laptop that you already replaced but mostly still works and is fit for everyday tasks like Office and light browsing under Linux. I simply can't imagine a scenario in which you need such a budget PC. Maybe a project computer, and you absolutely can't afford a 9th gen, for example, which is probably about $100 more, but it will last for the lifetime of Windows 11, maybe even Windows 12, and on top of that, for a few more years with Linux. The cost per year absolutely makes sense if you buy a Windows 11 compatible PC, even if you plan to use Linux on it. And I'm also going to give this example of how Microsoft basically has some voting power when deciding what is obsolete and what isn't. If you remember Itanium, that was Intel's original 64-bit architecture before AMD introduced AMD 64, which ultimately came to be known as X64 after Intel also adopted it. Microsoft and Intel discontinued Itanium in the same year, in 2020, one ending support, the other production. 3 years later, Linux stopped compiling for Itanium. This is what I'm talking about, that software follows hardware hand in hand, and that if Microsoft, as a big software player, decides to discontinue something, there is probably a reason for it. While I don't defend their choice of discontinuing every CPU before 8th gen, they had to draw the line somewhere. Windows 10 could run on the decade-old Pentium 4, and it was painful as hell. When they draw the line a little high, they make space for the development of new features and capabilities which won't be held back by ancient hardware, which is basically what happened with Internet Explorer. And with that being said, I'm ending the analysis. I hope you found the video interesting, and I also hope that you don't post any more negative feedback now that everything is factually correct. And to summarize the whole video with one sentence, basically, I'm not telling you to stop buying these PCs, but be aware that the age might one day become a problem, and that the articles might seem a little deceiving at first in the way they present these PCs. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe, and why don't you watch another one on my channel?